have seen the many faces of fear and of pain. I haven't watched the tears fall plenty from heartache and strain. So if life's journey has you weary and afraid, there's rest in the shadow of his wings. I remember driving home on the bus one night after a show. We were in New York, and I was just praying, saying, Lord, do you still want me to share my testimony? And a lot of people know my testimony and how I went through a battle of watching my wife go through cancer and then go be with Jesus. And as I sat there, I felt like God laid in my heart, and he started showing me all the different stories that I've heard and the signing lines or different notes that I may have read or things on my guest book on the website, and reminded me that this is a chapter in my life that he has given me. Now, I know that things have moved on. I've been very blessed to have an amazing family and two beautiful children, but it's still part of my life. And I remember just going back to that place throughout the years of talking to people and how they've shared, thank you so much for sharing your testimony, how God has brought you through this pain and this hard time and has been so faithful. And the scripture came to mind, 2 Corinthians 1:3. It says, blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and God of all comfort, who comforts us in all of our troubles, that we may be able to comfort those who are in any trouble with the comfort by which we have been comforted by God. For as the sufferings of Christ abound in us, so our consolation also abounds through Christ. Now, if we are afflicted, it is for your consolation and salvation, which is effective for enduring the same sufferings which we also suffer. If we are comforted, it is for your consolation and salvation. And our hope for you is steadfast, because we know that as you are partakers of the sufferings, so also you will partake of the consolation. And for me, I've been able to really share how God has been so faithful, how he has healed my heart and taken me through a difficult time and restored that from that deep and dark place in my life to a place of hope and to where I am now. And I never want to stop sharing that goodness of his faithfulness in my life. And I want to encourage you guys, the scripture where it says, cast all your cares upon him, for he cares for you. And it says that he is near to the broken and contrite spirit. And when we're going through those trials and tribulations, he's near. His hand is not far. He's right there, ready to reach out. And it says, hold on, as this song says, to what's being held out, the healing hand of God. I encourage you guys. It never says that we're not going to go through trials. It says actually in James that consider it pure joy when you face trials of many kinds. So it never promises that there will be a life that is perfect, because we're going to struggle and go through hardships. But what God promises is that he will stand right next to us and be there at every moment and be faithful to lead us and guide us and to heal our hearts. And I encourage you guys who have never maybe experienced a difficult trial, maybe nothing that's been very heavy in your life, and you may wonder, how can I relate to someone who's been through something so heavy? Man, pray for compassion, pray for understanding, pray for wisdom. God will give you. Doesn't mean you can't speak into somebody's life, because his word declares the truth. And God can give you an understanding and a compassion that is from him, because he knows, he can relate. He can do anything in your heart, and we can always direct everything to his promises. I have seen the healing hand of God reaching out and mending broken hearts. Taste and see the fullness of his peace, and hold on to what
And hold on to what's being held out, the healing hand of God.